Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture series offered by the PG Department of English, Bayanu College. Today we are going to learn a poem titled Curing Caste, written by Sahodaran Ayyappan. So who is Sahodaran Ayyappan? Sahodaran Ayyappan is an important figure when you think about Kerala's social and political history. He was a legislator, a writer, a journalist, a reformer and a revolutionary. He was born in the year 1889 at Charai in Cochin and he died in the year 1968. He wrote so many works and he actually promoted activities against social evils at all. And he famously said, "No caste, no religion and no God for man." He promoted a mixing of caste and he promoted something known as Misra Bhojanam, where people from different castes sit under one roof and dine together, eat together. So this thing, that is mixing of different people from different castes and eating together, was something that was unheard during that period. So he was a revolutionary. He wanted to eradicate social evils like caste and casteist thinking. And in his works also we can see the reflections or the remnants of these ideas. So he promoted social upliftment by eradicating so many social evils. And in the poem Curing Caste also, we can see the same spirit, same revolutionary spirit. In this poem also, he is talking against the idea of caste. And this work is actually originally written in Malayalam with the title Jadi Chikitsa Sangraham. And this poem was later translated into English by Dr. Ajay S. Shekhar, with the title Curing Caste. So before we begin the poem, let's understand or let's read the original Malayalam poem written by Sahodaran Ayyappan with the title Jadi Chikitsa Sangraham. So I'll be reading this poem. So Jadi Chikitsa Sangraham. Chikitsa cholvu rendu vidham jadi rogam porukkuvan പുറം രോപണമാമൊന്ന് മറ്റേതാന്തര ശോധനം. തൽക്കാല രാഷ്ട്രീയ ആവശ്യ ഭേഷജങ്ങൾ പുരട്ടിടും മുറിവൈദ്യം നടത്തുന്നു ജാതിരോപണവാദികൾ. പുറത്തും മായലും ജാതി മാറാരോപണ വേലയാൽ വലിഞ്ഞകത്ത് കോപിച്ചു ദുർവികാരങ്ങൾ കാട്ടിടും. വീമ്പും കുശുമ്പും ദുരയും ദേശീയത്തിൻ പ്രലാപവും ഉള്ളിൽ വലിഞ്ഞ ജാതിക്ക് ലക്ഷണം ചൊൽവോ സൂരികൾ. അതും കൊണ്ട് നടക്കുന്നോ ഇവിടെ കൂസലിങ്ങിയെ വായ തോരാതെ വർഗീയം പഴിച്ചുന്നതരാകയാം. ജാതി പോക്കാൻ ശ്രമിക്കാതെ ജാതീയത്തെ പഴിപ്പവർ തീകെടുത്താതെ ചൂടാറ്റും പാഴുവേല പ്രചാരകർ. പുറത്തുമുള്ളിലും ജാതി പോക്കുന്ന ആന്തരശോധനം അതിനു ജാതി വിശ്വാസം ഇല്ലാതാക്കണം ആദ്യമായി. ജാതി സത്യം, ജാതിധർമ്മം, ജാതി ഈശ്വര കൽപ്പിതം, ജാതി ലംഘിക്കുകയിൽ പാപം, ജാതിഭ്രഷ്ട വിനിന്ദിതം. ഈ വിധത്തിലേഴും മൂഢവിശ്വാസങ്ങൾ ഒരുക്കുവാൻ യുക്തൌഷധം വിധിക്കുന്നു ശോധനാമുറയൊരുവോർ. ജാതിവിശ്വാസ ശീലങ്ങൾ മാറുമ്പോൾ നമ്മൾ ആദ്യമായി മനുഷ്യനെ മനുഷ്യനായി കാണും ആരോഗ്യമാർഗനും. നരന്റെ ഗുണദോഷങ്ങൾ മഹത്വാൽപത്തരങ്ങളും അവന്റെ ജാതി നോക്കാതെ കണ്ടിടും ജാതി പോയവർ. എത്ര ബുദ്ധി വളർന്നാലും എത്ര വിദ്യ പഠിക്കലും ജാതി പോകാതെ ആ സിദ്ധി കൈവന്നിടില്ലൊരുത്തനും. സൊ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ഒറിജിനൽ പോം written by Sahodaran Ayyappan with the title Jadi Chikitsa Sangraham. And this poem was translated into English. As I told you, it was translated into English by Dr. Ajay S. Shekhar. And he gave the title Curing Caste. So this collection, I mean this poem can be seen in his book. That means Dr. Ajay S. Shekhar's book. Sahodaran Ayyappan towards a democratic future. So let's learn this poem, Curing Caste. I'll be reading the lines of this poem, and I'll be explaining this thing. So understand that before we begin the poem, you have to understand one fact that in this poem, Sahajan Ayyappan is considering caste as a kind of disease. So normally, what will we do if we are having a disease? We will try to cure that disease. We will try to find a solution for that disease, and we will try to cure that disease by applying different types of techniques and by taking different medicines at all. So here, this idea of caste is also considered as a kind of disease by Sahajan Ayyappan. Now, he is saying, or he is narrating, how we can cure this caste disease. So that is why this title, Curing Caste. We have to cure the disease called caste. So I'll be reading the first two lines of this poem. There are two types of cures for the caste disease. One from the outside and another from inside. So this is how the poet begins the poem. He tells that caste is a disease. So just like any other disease, this disease known as caste also needs cures. And there are two types of cures for the caste disease. And what is the speciality of these two cures for the caste disease? One should be from the inside and the other should be from the outside. That means we have to use external measures and internal measures to cure the caste disease. So that is how the poet begins the poem. And the poet tells that one type of cure is not enough for caste disease. If you want to eradicate caste completely, you should not concentrate on only one type of cure. We have to concentrate on both the methods. We have to cure caste internally and externally. So I'll be reading the next two lines. Some use external ointments to cure caste, and this is of transitory value. So here in these lines, the poet is talking about the external measures to cure the caste disease. Poet says that some people try to cure caste externally, but this is not enough. This is only having a transitory value, or it is not having any kind of permanent significance. It is only having a fleeting effect. This is not completely needed. We have to focus more. Simply applying external type of measures to remove caste externally is not enough. We have to focus on internal measures to eradicate caste disease. So for example, I'll tell you an example. If you're having a kind of skin disease, sometimes you apply some kind of external ointment and you won't take any kind of medicines internally. And by applying this external ointment, sometimes you feel that this skin disease is completely disappeared. But after some time, you may see that it is appearing again. That means that disease is not completely cured. So for some diseases, external measures are not enough. You have to concentrate on internal measures too, along with the external measures. So caste is a kind of a similar disease. Here we have to focus externally as well as internally to eradicate this disease completely. And the external measures may include some kind of restrictions regarding casteist type of expressions. We may force people that they should not show any kind of casteist type of attitudes towards anybody. And there are people who will follow that thing, and because they are afraid of laws and regulations, so they won't exhibit any kind of casteist type of behaviors. And when you look at the society, then you feel that, okay, caste is completely eliminated, eradicated. It may have gone inside and it may come out again. So, these external measures are not completely enough to eradicate caste completely. Sometimes we have to apply internal measures too. And the poet says, because of this reason, the poet says that these external or completely concentrating on the external measures only to eradicate caste may have transitory effect, may have fleeting effect. They don't have any kind of, they may not be showing, they may not show any kind of permanent significance. So now let me read the next two lines. Caste may disappear from outside, but it will retreat into the inside and do damage. So here in this session, in these lines, the poet says why he is saying that simply concentrating on external measures to eradicate caste will not give you any kind of benefit or will not give you a permanent kind of effect. Because he says that if we focus completely on external measures, then this disease may disappear outwardly, but it may go inside and it may grow there and it may develop there develop there internally, and which may damage the person or which may completely damage the society later. For example, as I told you earlier, sometimes take the instance that if in a society there are some kind of strict rules in which everybody is told that they should not show any kind of divisionism on the basis of caste, and they should not follow any kind of caste based rituals, they should not announce their caste publicly and all. So people follow this thing, and outwardly we feel that the society is completely free of caste type of thinking. But it may not be true. Why? Because there are people who completely believe that caste is essential. And these people may follow the rules and regulations because they are afraid of punishment. And inside their mind, you can see caste-based thinking growing, and these people nurture it inside their minds, and it will grow inside their mind, and when they get an opportunity, they will give an expression to these caste based feelings. That means caste is again appearing. So that is why the poet is saying that simply applying external measures is not enough. Because if we completely focus on external measures, sometimes caste may go inside, this disease may go inside your mind, and it may grow there and it may do more damage. Now I'll read the next two lines. Hate, gossip and nationalist rhetoric are symptoms of inwardly drawn caste, says sages. So now the poet is saying that he is talking about intellectuals, sages, people with great wisdom and all. And he says that these sages, they have told something about the caste disease. These sages said that you can see the symptoms of caste disease. We can see that in the expressions of certain people, the symptoms of inwardly drawn caste disease. There are some people who promote certain type of hate speeches, gossips, and extreme type of nationalist rhetoric, and nationalist type of speeches and all. And why these people are doing that thing? They're actually spreading hatred among people. They're actually dividing people by promoting these type of hate speeches, gossips and nationalist rhetoric. And these are actually symptoms of inwardly drawn caste disease. because in the minds of these people, they are actually nurturing the fact that people are different on the basis of their caste and creed. And they are dividing people with this belief. And they are actually dividing people by providing these hate speeches, by providing these type of false nationalist type of rhetoric and gossips. So all these things, all these measures that are taken by these people to divide people are actually symptoms of their insidely growing caste disease. And this is actually told by sages or wise people. Now I'll be reading the next two lines. Those who nurture it inside are becoming big shots in politics here through their hate rhetoric. So the poet is telling that those people who are nurturing the caste disease inside their mind, they're actually becoming politically prominent figures. How? Because they are dividing people, and by dividing people by using their hate speeches and all, they are actually getting the support of some other sections of society. So they are actually spreading hatred among people, and they are saying these politicians, these people who are nurturing caste disease inside their minds, they are spreading hatred among people. They are making people believe that one person is different from another person, and one person is dominant and the other person is inferior. So they are actually separating people, they are actually dividing people by using hate rhetoric, hate speeches and all. And by doing all these things, they are getting their own advantage. They are actually promoting their own political position. And by doing all these kind of methods to divide people, they are actually becoming very prominent political figures, and they are gaining advantages. So this is what Sahodaran Ayyappan has to say about those people who are nurturing casteist type of thinking inside their mind, or those people who are nurturing the caste disease inside their minds. So I'll be reading the next two lines. Those who curse caste without trying to alleviate it are trying to cool off without extinguishing the fire. So now the poet is talking about a particular type of people, a particular section of the society, who really know the fact that there are some people who know the fact that caste is a bad thing. It is a negative thing. It promotes negativity. And these people curse caste, but they don't do anything to eradicate caste or eradicate or cure this caste disease. But simply cursing, simply sitting there and cursing the caste disease will not give you any kind of benefit. He has actually given another example to showcase, to demonstrate this thing. He has said that, for example, if something is burning, if there is a kind of fire which is burning here, burning fire is here, and you know that in such a situation, there will be a very hot kind of air. The situation, the surroundings will be very hot if there is a burning fire. And if a person is sitting there, and if that person wants to get a cooler kind of atmosphere, a cooler air, but he is simply sitting there without extinguishing the fire, then there is no use. If you want to get cool air, you have to extinguish the fire. By simply sitting there without doing anything and complaining that, oh, the fire is burning and it is very hot here, will not give you any kind of cool kind of climate, cool kind of condition. So what you have to do, if you want to get a cooler kind of atmosphere, if you want to get a cooler kind of cool feeling, you have to extinguish the fire. So that is what Sahodaran Ayyappan is saying here. You can sit here, you can curse the caste, but it won't give you any kind of benefit. It is simply sitting there without extinguishing the fire, saying that you need cold kind of air. If you want to, if you know the negatives of caste, you should not sit simply cursing the caste. You have to do something to eradicate it. Without doing anything, and if you sit there and just curse the climate or curse the caste, it won't give you any kind of benefit. Instead, it is completely worthless. This procedure is completely worthless. So that is what he is saying here. And now I'll be reading the next two lines. To eradicate caste from inside and outside, first, the faith in caste must go. That caste is truth, caste is morality, and caste is divine. And breaking the caste is taboo, and being casteless is a shame. So now, the poet is saying that if you want to eradicate caste, you have to do it internally and externally. You cannot concentrate only on one method to cure the caste disease. So, there is a way to cure caste internally and externally. How can you do that? There is one way, and this way is to ensure that the faith in caste has gone. So, what does he mean? He says that people actually believe in caste. People actually, they are having a kind of faith in caste. Only if we can remove this faith in caste, we can eradicate this caste disease internally and externally. So, we have to ensure this fact that the caste or the faith in caste has gone. So, what is the faith in caste? What does actually we believe? What does actually we believe regarding caste disease? The people believe that caste is truth. People believe that caste is morality. People believe that caste is God-given. Caste is divine. People believe that they cannot live without caste. And they believe that if you break a caste, if you live without caste, it is a taboo. It is not accepted. People believe that it is a kind of shame to live without caste. So this is actually their faith in caste. They have complete trust in caste, which should be completely eradicated. And if a person or if somebody wants to cure the caste disease internally and externally, they should ensure this fact that the caste or the faith in caste has completely removed. So, now let's see the next two lines. These dogmas must go, and the medico must ensure it through proper medication for cleansing. So, the poet tells that this belief in caste must be gone away, must be gone. This trust in caste must be removed, must be eradicated. These dogmas and these beliefs in caste should be completely eliminated. Only then we can cure the caste disease. And those people, those physicians, those medicos, those professionals who are cleansing the minds of people should ensure this thing. That means the social reformers who are trying to eradicate the caste disease should ensure the fact that they are actually removing the faith in caste completely. They should provide proper medication to do this cleansing process. They should make sure that the faith in caste has gone. Only then we can see a society that is completely cured of caste disease. Now I'll be reading the next three lines. When the dogmas and conventions of caste change, we see human as human and become healthy and normal. So the poet tells that if we can eradicate the caste disease completely, if we can cure the caste disease completely, then we will be healthy. Then we can see human beings as human beings. Then we can lead a normal life. So I'll tell you an example. What will happen if you are having a disease? We will be unhealthy. We will not be normal. But what will happen if we can cure that disease? Then we will be healthy and we can lead a normal life. So the same thing happens in the case of caste disease also. If you can cure caste disease completely, then you will be having a healthy life and a normal life. Then you will be actually able to see human beings as human beings. Then there won't be anything to divide human beings. So that is the thing that you have to do. If you can actually see human beings as human beings, only if you can cure the caste disease. So that is what Sahodzimayyappan is saying here. Now let's see the next two lines. The faults and qualities of a person are truly identified by those who are cured of the caste disease. So what is the benefit of curing the caste disease? Only those people who are cured of caste disease can really see the merits and demerits of a person. Because then there won't be anything to divide human beings. So otherwise, if a person is not cured of caste disease, then if a person analyzes or examines another human being, that person will be thinking about the caste of that person. So there will be a kind of partiality in the judgment made by a person if that person is having a caste type of attitude. If you support a particular caste, if you belong to a particular caste, then you look at another person and you will actually analyze that person's merits and demerits only on the basis of the caste to which that person belongs. If you are completely cured of caste disease, then there won't be anything to divide people. Then you will see the real human being. Then you will be really able to see the merits and demerits of a person in its true sense. So that will be the benefit that you will get if you are completely cured of caste disease. Now the poet concludes, how much you study and how much your intelligence grows, you can't gain this potential without getting rid of caste. So the poet is telling that you can be an intellectual, you can study so much, you have got a greater education, you are an intellectual, but if your mind is not completely cured of this caste disease, then you will never be able to examine a person in his true sense. You will never be able to see the true merits and demerits of a person if you are not cured of the caste disease. So how much you study, how much you learn, or even if you are an intellectual, nothing will happen. You will never get this potential to examine a person's merits and demerits correctly if you are not cured of the caste disease. So if you want to have true judgment, if you want to have true capacity to understand people, then make sure that you are completely cured of the caste disease. So with this idea, Sahodzimayyappan ends the poem. So in this poem, once again I am summarizing that thing. The poet considers caste as a kind of disease, and he tells that this disease should be cured internally as well as externally. And in order to cure this disease, we should completely eliminate the belief or the faith in caste. Only then a human being can see another human being's merits and demerits in its true sense without any kind of partiality.
Now let us discuss the short answer questions given in the text. First question. What, according to the author, are the two types of cures for caste disease? Answer. There are two types of cures for the caste disease, according to the author. One type of cure is from the outside and another from the inside. Second question. Why are external ointments not effective for the caste disease? Answer. External ointments are not effective for the caste disease as they only function externally and they are of transitory value. Third question. What are the symptoms of caste disease according to sages? Answer. Hate, gossips, and nationalist rhetoric are symptoms of inwardly drawn caste disease according to sages. Fourth question. Explain the phrase hate rhetoric. Answer. Hate rhetoric is a persuasive language or speech which is derogatory and it lacks sincerity. Question number 5. How do those who have faith in caste glorify caste? Answer. Those who have faith in caste glorify caste by considering it as truth, morality, and God-given. They assume that breaking the caste is taboo. Moreover, they believe that being casteless is a shame. Question number 6. Whom does the medico in the poem represent? Medico is a physician. In the poem, this word represents a social reformer who is curing the caste disease. Question number 7. What is meant by the word dogma? Answer. Dogma means blind faith or unquestioned belief. Question number 8. What happens when the dogmas and conventions of caste change? Answer. When the dogmas and conventions of caste change, we begin to see human as human. We also become healthy and normal. Question number 9. What is the power gained by those who are cured of the caste disease? Answer. The power to understand the faults and qualities of a person is gained by those who are cured of the caste disease. Question number 10. Mere intelligence and learning are not sufficient to gain full human potential. What else is needed? Answer. To achieve full human potential, one should be cured of the caste disease. Thank you.